Okay.
All
All right.
right, we're gonna do this. Yeah, we're live, and it looks like it's going. I think. All right.
What, we're live?
Are we?
What?
Are
Are
we
we live?
live? Can somebody tell me if we're live? This is my stream manager. Oh, yeah, we're live. 28 seconds ago.
All
Wait, so
right.
the last 28 seconds have been live? Uh-oh.
Okay. Here we go. All right. No viewers yet, so we'll just go with it.
Okay.
I changed
so that's
the time
safe.
To 7, so that's only 15-minute difference, so they might have got bored. All right. We are live, and I think we have everyone in here, right?
That's fine.
Hey, hey, the gang's all here.
Yeah, we're missing.
Yeah, we're here.
Yeah.
Except Desmondo.
Desmond, yeah.
And you notice his name of his character and his picture on there, right? Marcus the Red.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know
he's Mark.
Mark is, right? He's Mark, so.
Yeah, nice.
That's definitely appropriate at this point.
So, oh, we got some reverb.
Yeah,
I heard we're hearing you twice.
Yeah, no, it's coming through Cindy's mic too.
Okay.
And we'll figure that out later. I'll talk softly. All right. Let's see. We are going to first clear the chat. Oh yeah, clear current chat. There we go. Because I was running some tests, and you don't need to see what was in there.
Oh.
Yeah.
Yes, I do. I've already screenshotted. It's okay.
Yeah, I did too.
Did you? Hey, anybody can look on Twitch and make sure our character thing is showing on there where the characters show up, where you can check and look at their stats. That'd be awesome. So we get started. It should be. Should be up there.
Should we have a black screen?
No, I don't know. Why are you seeing a black screen too? I don't understand it.
Does everybody else have black screen?
Oh, no, I know why you are, because you weren't signed
nope.
up before. So we're going to put you in right now. Hang on.
Okay.
See, you weren't in there before. You just signed in.
Why wasn't I?
Because you didn't sign into the adventure yet.
Because you didn't have a computer.
Yeah, you didn't have a computer. Okay. How about that now?
Raider touchdown.
Is that better?
Let's go.
Nope. It's still black.
Okay. Hang on.
Who got the touchdown?
Waller.
Good.
Everybody
Anyone but Jacobs.
Yeah, he almost did.
Did everybody change their character names on their actual name in the system so they'll show?
If Maddie's team ends up, or if Drew Brees and Jacobs end up scoring 50 six points and I lose, I'm gonna be pissed.
Yep.
All right, we're back. Okay, so Mecca's good. Who's good?
We're missing John.
Oh, I need to. Do you want me to change my
yes
display
yes.
name?
Display
yes.
name.
Troy.
I don't know.
Everyone bear with us here. If you're watching viewers, we're getting ready to start the adventure. Oh, I know why. I have to click a button that says show nameplate. How about that?
Hey, there it is.
All right.
All right, cool.
Yeah.
I'm stream sniping you.
Hey, hey, Irish Thunder. Oh, wait. No, that wasn't tonight. That was an old MTV feed. It said sent you 3 bits.
Yeah, that was last night.
That was last night.
Way to stay on it, streamer.
I know, I'm so good. I talked to the chat people 2 days.
Professional.
2 days after it happens.
Better late than never.
Right. Okay.
Hey, I made $300 on stream last night.
I thought you might have, because after your birthday thing.
Truffle shuffle.
That was pretty crazy. We got Rick to do the truffle shuffle on his stream.
It was epic.
Yeah, one guy gifted like a full, 12 months of subs?
15 tier one subs.
15 tier one subs. And then he didn't have a
and
choice.
Then I had another 10 after that.
Yeah, he didn't have a choice. He had to do the truffle shuffle. And it was pretty hilarious. It's clipped, too. So We'll have to play that clip sometime.
Now we know what your dignity costs.
Hey,
yeah. Whatever it takes. I do things for money.
Yeah, whatever it takes.
Money talks.
Hey, don't we all?
Right. You don't want to know what I would do for money.
Yeah.
It's just how deep you'll go.
Exactly.
All right.
DM me, Rob. DM me.
I think we're. Did anybody look at that Twitch to make sure the character's showing there?
Yeah, I think it's all showing.
Oh, it is? Nice.
Yeah, I think I saw it on there.
Rob, we look like brothers.
Okay. Right?
All right, well, we're going to get started. We have more viewers popping in there, so let's do it. We're starting a little bit later than we normally would, but we need a little bit more setup time. This is a brand new adventure, so we are going to get started. So let's go do some character introductions here. I think that's the best way to start.
FYI, one of the tokens doesn't have a name.
Do what?
One of the tokens doesn't have a name.
There's a token that doesn't have a name.
Who? Chamberlain?
Whoever that guy is.
Is that Chamberlain?
Oh, yeah, hang on.
It shows a name on my
pretty
screen.
Sure that's
yeah, got a name.
Oh, I know why.
It's the reason why I only see black.
Okay, how about now?
I have a name.
There you go.
I still don't understand why you're seeing black there, Pimdoll.
I'll just go old school D&D and just use my imagination.
Oh, no. Don't do that.
I bet there's like a checkbox you have to click.
I'm looking right
that
now.
I have to click?
I do not know. I don't see it. I've looked through the token like 3 times and it still shows.
I can make a circle. Do you guys see my circle?
I think there's a circle. Well, everybody out in Streamland will see you on there right now. So
cool.
We'll see what happens when you get over to the other screen. Yeah, if you get that. Okay.
You don't have Fog of War on, do you?
There you go. No. So, yeah, in the chat, Irish Thunder just put the clip. Is that you doing the trouble shuffle?
Yeah, that should be it.
Okay, it's in the chat right now, so anybody can view that if they want.
Hot.
Yeah. Okay, let's do this. Icewind Dale. Heck yeah. Let's get some mood stuff going on here. Mood music to do the introductions.
Are we taking requests?
Not yet. We will be doing that at some point.
Because I'd say Holy Diver by Dio.
Ooh, that's a good one. Holy Diver. It was either that or something by Taylor Swift for me. No, it's Holy Diver, though.
What about that song from Thor, the Icewind, the galloping song?
Oh.
That narrows it
from
down.
From Ragnarok?
Oh, yeah. You're talking about Immigrant Song?
Yeah.
Yes. Do that one. I mean, it makes sense.
Do you have a pro account?
On what?
On Roll20.
Pro, I think I have the one right before that.
Okay. Because you might have John's vision turned off with the advanced tab, there should be like a light source.
Okay.
I'm looking at reasons.
No, I mean, like I said, I ran. The settings are exactly the same as the other characters.
Try shift clicking on the screen. He might be off on a different map.
Shift click.
Just like shift and hold shift and clicks. Like on one of us. Saying he might be on another layer or something.
Okay. Well, I'm just gonna keep moving forward and see how it goes.
All right.
We'll figure it out.
Yeah.
If he shows
works
up on,
for me.
If he shows up on the other screen, he should.
You, how about this? I'll tune into the stream and just tell you where I need to go.
Yeah, there you go.
Change your name on your character, did you?
I changed my little box name to my actual character name.
On your,
no, that's
you
no,
your camera.
On, yeah. No, he's saying on on D&D Beyond.
On D&D Beyond
nope, I'm still Himble Dork Slayer. Slayer of Dorks.
The door shutter.
Okay, it shows
It's all right.
Oh, no, that's what it is.
In the other campaign, Bindi has the dork saber.
I got it.
It's not even a dark saber. It's the dork
saber.
Not
a dork saber.
Now. Don't tell me you know why. Show me you know why.
There you go. See it now?
Oh, hey!
Break
on through to the other side.
This is Himble right here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. I just want to make sure. Because the names have to match who's controlling them when we do it. So this little training session for anybody watching.
Mine works.
Mine works.
Okay.
Varys looks like Desmond.
He totally does.
All right. Let's do this. We got five beers out there.
Did you really make a Loxodon?
Yes.
He did. Uh-oh.
I'm a woolly mammoth person.
Messing with their characters cool. right now. So.
Yeah. All right, you just told us to.
Yeah, that's fine. Okay, so let's start. Let's do this. So welcome everybody to Icewind Dale, Rhyme of Frostmaiden. We've been looking forward to this. This is a really great adventure. I hope you like cold. That's really important. You gotta like cold.
I hate the cold.
Of course, we'll all start off with a set of cold weather clothing, like we talked about. And when we were doing character creation. And that all set up. We've already done all the character creation with everybody that might be listening. There's several different things that the characters can get at the start of the adventure, including some extra background. There's some secrets that they may choose to reveal or not during the adventure. They will definitely come into play during the adventure, for the most part. Not all of them might, but you never know. We'll see. Pretty exciting. So it's all tied in. To their characters, different things are going to happen in the adventure, and they basically, unless they've read ahead and looked at spoilers online, they don't know what's going to happen. And a little disclaimer, if you're going to play an adventure with the DM with this, don't watch. You're going to see a lot of spoilers. But just before you go, make sure you follow us. Make sure you do that. Or watch us after you've played a couple of sessions with your DM, then you'll be good. We're going to do kind of an introductory adventure into Icewind Dale. We may make it into the first kind of layers of it, but that's kind of a first session, introduce characters. Bradley said the sound is echoing bad on the stream. Yeah. We're working on that. We'll see what we can come up with. Anybody else notice that? Just any echo? Is it echo just when I'm talking, or
I could? Yeah, it just seems like it's you to me.
Really,
it's good in here for me. Like, it's perfect.
It's not too distracting or anything.
It's not distracting. Okay,
it's better than it's been ever been for me.
Okay, good.
Because it's usually I can hear you on two microphones.
Oh, okay, good. Okay,
but this sounds great.
All right, good. No problem. That was what I was mostly concerned about. Yeah, because I was going through my camera mic before, and it was really bad. Okay, so we're going to get going here, and we're going to do some character introductions first. So whoever wants to start, give us your – you don't have to give us your real name. You can give your character name. And just a little bit about your character that you wish to reveal at this point, since all the other characters are listening. So, yeah. So whoever wants to go first? Anybody? We do alphabetical order. Do we do that?
I can go.
Who's going?
I know it. All right. So my character's name is Himble Dorkslayer. I get my surname from the Yeti that I killed outside of the town of Tenzin. I was only armed with my lance and a trusty companion, Cooper, that always travels with me. Which is my riding dog, who's basically a Saint Bernard. But yeah, I'm a little weird looking. Not only am I halfling and really short, but like I'm almost like really stocky, Like all shoulders, no legs. I skip leg day for my entire life because I use my dog as much as possible.
Are you by chance yellow and live in a pineapple under the sea?
No, but I am a paladin also of Thorm. Thorm.
Thorm.
I was about to say a paladin of Thorm. That could be good.
Interesting. We can work with that.
Okay, yeah. Cindy's going to use her headset mic, too, so I think that's going to be better rather than her Zoom mic.
Yeah. How does that work? Actually, your mic's not even coming through because you have to set it on there to be to your headset mic. So. You'll be okay if you use the other one. Just talks off.
Okay, we're gonna keep going. All right, who wants to be next?
I'll go next. Hi, I'm Chamberlain. I'm a cleric. I'm a traveling cleric, traveling healer. I travel to all the poorer parts of the Sword Coast to try to uplift spirits and, you know, stop people from dying. I live really, really poorly, really almost in squalor. All of my excess money goes to the church, and I came to Icewind Dale in search of ruins and artifacts left behind by the giants that used to live there. And that's all you get.
I shall tell you nothing else.
All right, who's next?
All right, I'll go next. My character is Yarzo Monsoom. I'm a male water genasi wizard. And I actually as well came here to looking for ruins and artifacts. I strive in life to learn more. Like I'm always trying to learn. I'm in search of knowledge. I'm very in tune with the local universities in Waterdeep, where I'm from, and that's why I'm here. I'm looking for knowledge. I want to find artifacts and learn more about the giants.
Nice. Okay. Yeah. So Yarzi, you just got a comment that you're very clear.
My mic?
Yeah, you were super clear.
Nice. That's that Jabra.
Nice. Okay. All right. Who is next?
I'll go. My name is Abar Hoppy, and I have come to the town seeking kind of the knowledge from the town. I've kind of lived in the wilderness most of my life, amongst some of the tribes out there. And I believe that the town has more knowledge to offer. So I've come to seek it.
Nice.
And what are you? You're a giant.
I am a Loxodon monk.
So, like, when you say wilderness, do you mean the savannah?
No, I mean the tundra.
Okay. So you're.
I am less elephant, Loxodon. More mammoth.
Nice. That's pretty cool. All
right. Are there people are almost extinct?
Huh?
Are there many of you in your tribe, or like you started?
My tribe was actually not a tribe of Loxodons.
Oh, okay.
There were as many races represented, and it was more of a tribe that had come together as for survival. So.
Nice.
Goliaths, humans, some hardy dwarves.
Cool. All right. Next. Who is next?
Cindy, do you want to go before me, or do you want to go last?
Fine.
I'm going to manipulate me to hear what you say, and then I'll be where I'm from, where you're from. No.
I was a halfling stout. I was killed, and I finally healed it.
Okay, your mic went through all crap. Weird. Why don't you flip back to your boom mic? She said mine was cleared up, so. Okay. Who is next?
I'll go next. I am Carhu the bear, not an actual bear. Although that would have been cool. I am a barbarian from the Sky Pony tribe in the spine of the world, follower of Tempest, and I look forward to killing many foes with you guys. It's as long as you're not a magic user.
Oh, great.
Then we'll have to work out why I don't hate you, but you know, it shouldn't be too hard.
I guess we're not going to get along.
Nice. So the arcane or the religious variety, or both?
Well, you know, the only kind I respect is shamans. So if you're of a spiritual persuasion, it probably won't be that big a deal. And there may be a couple of secrets in there you find out about me too later. But
do you believe in magic?
Oh yeah, I've slain many a wizard, many a well, not anybody's, you know, of great renown, but you know, little piddling sorcerers and goblin shamans and such that have dared show their face to my tribe.
We're gonna have to stay on separate ends of the marching order.
But I have yet to go out on my own and kill one, so we'll see how I do without a whole bunch of other barbarians behind me.
Okay, reconnect.
Also, I'm married to Maka. No, not really. Did you say what tribe you're from? Are you one of the Icewind Dale barbarians?
I did not.
No, okay, that's fine. I won't put you on the spot.
Is that better? Yeah, you're fine. Testing 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, it sounds better.
Yeah.
Okay.
Much
better.
Okay. Okay. So Cindy is clear. Okay. Hey, we took care of our technical problems. We've been here long. Okay. Who's left?
Barris.
I'm Barris. I am the captain of the town guard of 10 towns. We are trained to fight the orcs and other creatures and monsters throughout 10 towns in protection. But I feel that their training is no longer relevant for the coming terrors, and I feel that there's a necessity for more than just your traditional style training. So my whole nature and life, and what I'm striving to do is to protect the people of 10 towns at all costs by any means necessary, while destroying any and all monsters that come across my path.
That's everybody.
That's it. Marcus the Red.
He's going to be Mark.
Mark.
Yeah. Does anybody know who Mark is? Can we get a shot of who Mark is? No? Yeah.
He's going to show up in about 20 minutes. He's going to kill everything, and then he's going to go back away.
And he'll always be in the background somewhere.
Like Mark and the gamers.
Mm-hmm, yeah, mm-hmm. Gamers. Okay. Let's do this.
Before those Critical Role pretty boys came around for gamers.
There was the gamers.
Hey, you leave Matt Mercer out of this, okay?
All right. Compliment.
I like all the negative space in Fluff's window.
Yeah.
Yep.
It makes it feel like you're really short.
I am.
He's role playing as his elephant. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I was going to say, if that's the case, then I should be much bigger.
I just want to know, Abar, if you want a peanut. I'm going to have to say that at least once.
No. Nope. I'm actually deathly allergic, and for offering, I might just hit you.
What about circus peanuts?
Ew,
what about packing peanuts?
Ew. You don't get those animals. Don't you on them?
No, I can eat those.
Those are actually potato.
Those are Cheetos.
Styrofoam?
Rice.
Those organic packing peanuts? Ooh. So, yeah,
you can eat peanuts now.
I like where this game is going.
Yes, I'll talk to you about that. I'm
getting focus.
Focus.
Focus, Danielson.
Okay, so
Barris, that means you actually know me then, because I would have like been one. I saved the town of a Yeti attack.
Well,
nope, never heard of you.
Unless you're like a new. Unless you're like a newly appointed guard.
You are who?
Oh. No, that you don't understand. That town gets attacked by a Yeti at least 3 times a week.
Oh, okay.
So.
Probably the same Yeti. I probably didn't kill it all the way.
Here, yeah, we go.
Okay, so one thing we're going to assume as we get started here is that you are all familiar with Iceland Dale's basic geography in my parts. So you know about the various locations of the settlements that are part of the town. There are actually several different towns that are part of the town. So.
I sure hope so. I am the captain of 10 towns. I should know it.
Yeah. You don't go to number 9.
No. We don't go to District 9. We leave that alone. Something took over. Became a
how far inland is it?
Well, we're
going to
say that from the coast.
Do you have a picture, a map, or anything?
Yeah, I'll leave that in. And we'll see if I can put a map. Still work my way around this stuff. we'll put that up here in a little bit, and then we'll be able to show you. I'll look for it as we go. Let's see. Okay. So, let me get back over where I was. Okay. All right. So, basically, all of you, unless you have some kind of connection to each other and may have discussed with each other, you are basically talking to each other at this point. So, did that happen? Did anybody talk to each other about each other?
No, I didn't want to make that kind of plan without you saying.
Okay. That's fine.
You might have had some cool thing planned now.
Well, yeah. Okay.
I'm hunting Yarzo.
Oh, jeez. And I'm new to town. I just showed up.
Yeah. Okay. Well, basically, what we're going to do is you all, for some reason, traveled away from the 10 towns on some type of business, and you're going to be returning to 10 towns. You're basically kind of wilderness. You're on your way back to 10 towns. That's going to work. If you don't have my survey. So let me. Okay. So what you know about ICBL has become trapped in a perpetual winter. Ferocious blizzards make mountain paths through the spine of the world exceedingly treacherous. And this land has not felt the warmth of the sun in over 2 years. Okay, this is something that's currently happening in ICBL. In fact, the sun no longer appears above the mountains, not even in what should be the height of summer. In this frozen tundra, darkness and bitter cold reigns and clean. Most daily residents blame all the frostmaking, the gothic winter's wrath. The shimmering aurora that moves across the sky each night is said to be heard by a potent spell that keeps the sun at bay. The elf folk live scattered in their settlements, known as Ten Towns. They drop off in caravans coming from the south and travel between the settlements, and this never-ending winter has left everyone feeling isolated. Although each town has resolved to appease the frost maiden with sacrifices of one kind or another, no respite from winter fury seems forthcoming. For adventurers such as yourselves, Ten Towns is a place to test one's mettle. And in the spirit of heroes who come before, leave one's mark on this frigid, vibrant land. Okay? So as I said, you're familiar with, and I'll get that poster map up there when I find it. You're familiar with geography, the location of the settlements that comprise 10 towns. And let's see, there's other information that you might know. Okay. If you spend some time in 10 towns, you know the names of important residents, such as the speaker of each town. You will know information about each town's national description. And you'll, as we come to towns, then I'll be back to you. You also know the names of the four tribes of Red Deer Nomads. Okay. Is there anyone that has direct connection to any Red Deer Nomads, or did you know in any of your background?
Yes.
I'm an Uthgard barbarian.
Okay. This is basically for anyone who might have been part of the tribe, but you, some of you have some information about each tribe, some of the reputations of some of the prominent members, so that's stuff that you may know if you go. Now, Goliath, okay, which we have with Goliath. You know over some information too. This real quick. This will be something that I'll need to know, so I have to tell you that. We didn't have the dwarves, right? No dwarves?
Nope.
Okay. I don't worry about that.
I might have a second cousin who might have been a dwarf, but not sure. Yeah, okay. I'm so stalky.
Yeah. All right. Well, we're going to get started, and we're going to go for it right now. So you guys are traveling back from somewhere, coming back to Icewindale. And I'm going to stay him way over here. We're going to get on the other map. Everybody that's watching is seeing the map right now before you guys. So they all creepers there. But I'm just going
to see. So what you're saying is I should have your stream open to see the map before.
Right.
Well.
Right.
Hey, Kurt.
Green snipe.
Yeah.
Can I call an audible?
An audible.
Nope.
Can I get a token for my companion?
Token for your companion? Okay.
His riding dog.
Yes. I don't have one away, but you can. Well, if you're going to use it, we'll just assume it's there.
Okay.
For now. And then next time we'll put it in.
All right.
Okay. Oh, yeah, people are saying in the chat. Is that better? People get that.
We'll only know if you keep talking.
Well, I know why, because my mic is off. Wow, that means they—that means they didn't hear anything except it was coming through Cindy's mic. That's awesome. Okay, well at least they heard some of it. All of you heard it. Wow, that was great. I love that. Just say it, Rick.
I'm not saying nothing.
Just say it. Rookie streamer.
Just
gonna
sit over here and. Keep an eye on things.
Well, at least they heard some of it because they heard it through the other mic. So
at least we learned stuff today.
Yeah, you did. We're learning. So turn it up real loud when you guys watch the video after the fact.
It's okay. My third day streamer left my mic on while I was
superior
peeing.
Firepower.
When you were peeing?
Yeah, it's nothing like coming back to your chat and saying, hey, we can hear you. And how much water did you drink?
It was water.
It's like a camel.
It was water.
Okay.
Joke's on you. It was all beer.
It was all beer. Okay. All right. We're going to get you guys over to the map now. Let me get this set up. And here we go.
Why was there a weird ting at the end?
Moving the players.
You guys, why am I surrounded?
You guys there?
Oh, we forgot to tell you, John.
You right. Are the sacrifice.
All right. Can you guys see your tokens?
Also, we didn't hear it. We're good.
Mm-hmm. Everybody good?
Yes.
See your tokens?
See, he agrees.
Hey, so you can see your token, Himbo?
There you go. I'm somewhere around here, I bet.
Yeah, just scan around.
Hey, my name's not there.
Oh, yeah, you're not, huh? Hang on.
We're missing names on a couple players.
Gotcha. Right there. Who else is missing? Nobody? Everybody good?
You're missing the name on Chamberlain and on... Mecca.
Chamberlain. Where's Chamberlain?
Mecca.
Oh. All right.
Mecca.
Mecca. Mecca. No, you got to pronounce the H a little bit more. It's Mecca. Mecca.
More phlegm. Yeah. More Yiddish.
More phlegm.
Yiddish.
Mecca. Blahayim.
Chamberlain. Blahayim. Okay. Let me see if I can get Chamberlain's name on there real quick.
Oh, I see my name. That's weird.
Is it? You see it?
I see my name.
Okay.
We don't see his name.
Really?
That's weird.
That is weird.
everyone else took a drink, so.
All right.
I'm empty.
Everybody else good?
The dark crystal. Chamber.
Oh, yeah. I didn't even think about that.
All right. Everybody else good? Can you see your character?
Yeah.
All right. Oh, my music didn't stay on.
We're still missing names on two of them.
Barris? Barris good?
No, I'm good.
Abar? Oh.
Who are they?
I see.
Yeah, those two.
Yeah, so that's... that's going to be... Oh, yeah, here we go. And there we go. Mecca? See her now? Got her name?
Yep.
Okay. Do we have everybody? I think the only one I don't have... Karu... I don't have your hit points in there. Let's see.
Chamberlain doesn't have a name on it yet.
Really? He said he could see it.
I can't see it. No, it's a token.
Yeah, I don't see it either.
Hmm. Oh, no, I got it. I see what's going on. I got it. Yeah, I'm still learning here, people. Okay, how about now?
Yep.
Yep.
Okay. And Karu, what's your starting hit points? Karhu. Karhu.
What was that?
Yeah, sorry. I forgot to mute it. 15.
15? Got it.
My confetti. Ooh.
Okay. Now you should be able to see your hit points. All right. Okay, everybody. Well, Mark, as supposed to happen, Mark is standing off on the side over there, just staring into the... into the snow.
Into the void?
Into the void, yeah. Okay, so let me get my sound effects didn't stay going. That's funny. All right, there we go. All right.
It's because it's over.
No, it's not over. There is a... So you're traveling back from where we were to 10 towns, and you find yourself, which often happens in Icewind Dale, a huge blizzard just blew in. If you were traveling with anyone else, you were separated in this blizzard from them. And
like a joined twin.
Yeah, it's a total whiteout. Yeah, it's a total whiteout.
That must have hurt.
You don't see any of the other characters that you see on the map there. So we have to role play. There, you don't see any other characters. You find yourself in a whiteout, and you can't see anything around you. It's the temperature drops significantly. It's very, very cold. So if you have your cold weather gear, so that helps, obviously. But it seems so strangely cold, more than you've ever felt it before. It's even starting to bite through your cold weather clothing. And besides the fact that you can't see more than a foot ahead of you, the snow is blinding. It's blowing really strong. It's blowing so strong that you need to make a strength check. Everyone needs to make a strength check. You have to start with strength, yeah. So go ahead and roll. And
athletics or just...
Strength. Right. You might have to reset your roll thing on your settings for it to roll on the screen.
Yeah, I think so.
Because we have to reset. Good. So do the enable 3D dice, automatically roll 3D dice, and just save, and then I think it'll automatically do it. But
yeah, there's no save feature.
Yeah. You should be able to just do that, and next roll it'll go on there. Okay, so Yarzo Monsoon, you rolled an 8. You immediately, Abar Hathi, you rolled a 2?
Yep.
Okay.
Wow.
It's a big elephant.
And he's a big elephant guy. And
big elephant
just...
that just went flying into one of you guys.
Yeah. Oh, there we go. Somebody just rolled their dice. Sweet. Barris, or Mecca. Was that Mecca that just rolled?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah, your ears caught the wind, Abar.
Cindy, do you have any modifiers?
Did you roll your strength off your...
It doesn't look like that took your modifier.
Oh, yeah. You have to roll it from right there. Yeah.
There's no...
Just click it.
and then clear that. Did you enable your dice? Oh, you just rolled right now. Okay, yeah, you're good. You just have to roll your...
I roll from here.
Oh, no, no, you don't roll from there. Anything from there. You roll there.
Yeah,
I know why. Because you don't have the extension installed. Yeah, you don't have the DVD on extension installed. So just roll, and then we'll add your modifier in.
Okay. Plus 4.
Plus 4? Okay.
So 12?
Okay. Karu?
Well, I've seen a horse 17. Fly. 17. I've seen a dragon fly. I've seen a house fly.
I ain't ever seen an elephant fly.
Okay, so let me go back to what I was saying.
Sorry,
Disney. So Yarzu, you like just basically have blown over.
Get into tomorrow.
Okay.
Ignore that one. That was
blown over prone.
You're blown over prone. Yeah, you're prone. You got blown over from the snow, and the snow is just like piling up on top of you as you fell. You try to get up, but the wind just blows you back over. Same thing with Abar. You just get blown over. You're just laying prone on the ground. The snow is starting to cover over you. It's getting bitterly cold, and yeah.
Is that still not working?
What's not working?
I'm trying to get it to make the roll the dice. Roll.
Oh.
Dice.
Yeah.
I don't have mine turned on.
Did you click the little B?
Yeah, I did.
Oh.
Okay. It's no problem. As long as it's rolling on the chat, that's what matters.
Let's try this. Did that work? Nope.
I see it.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's going into the chat, it's just no dice are actually popping on the screen.
Do you see them on your Beyond page?
Nope. Hmm. Oh well, I'll figure it out.
It's no big deal. Okay. So, Abar, Yarzu, I think everybody else is good. And Mecha, you got a 12?
Yes.
12. You actually get blown down, but you feel like that you could maybe get up, but it's hard for you to get up. The wind's blowing so strong, it's starting to it is slowing you down. Yeah, Abra is prone. All right. So, what do you do? What is everybody doing? Let's just go right around down the list. Abar, what are you doing?
I will attempt to get up.
Okay.
So.
Okay. Roll another strength check with disadvantage.
Okay. Let's do this. Nope. 4.
Okay. All right. So you basically try to get up, keep moving, but you just can't do it. You fall back down. You're starting to get. It's weird. You're getting weirdly cold. Like I said, your cold weather clothing is protecting you for the most part, but you're starting to get really cold to where you feel like. You can't barely move. You're starting to feel a little disoriented. And yeah, it's getting tough to move.
At least you're really playing into your woolly mammoth part.
Okay. Let's keep going around. Oh, is there anything else you wanted to do in particular at this point?
Nope.
Okay. Let's go to Yarzo next.
What was the setup for this? I might have missed it, but what are we doing out here?
Just okay,
where
we are.
We're on our way back to town.
You're on your way back to Ten
to
Towns,
okay,
yes.
Got it.
So for whatever reason, you were away from town, you're coming back. And so Abar...
Do we know each other at this point?
No, you do not. You do not.
Okay.
Okay, so Abar also, one other thing I forgot to mention is that you're starting to feel like you're losing your direction of where you were supposed to be going. So let's deal with, let's just go across the list. Yarzo, what are you doing?
Do I see anybody near me?
You make a perception check.
That's a good call.
See if it rolls. Oh, it did. Nice.
Nice. It worked.
Ooh, not real good, though.
11 perception. Okay. You look in one direction, and for a moment, you think you saw the shape of a figure walking, struggling along, walking in the snow, but you couldn't quite make it out. It was just a fleeting glance. You think you saw something.
Okay, yeah, I'm going to try to stand up on my own then.
Okay, go ahead, do another strength check with disadvantage. Okay.
Oh, that's going to be my roll, probably.
Yeah. Disadvantage, that's 6 and 14, so 6. Okay, yeah. So you try to pull yourself up. You basically, it just knocks you back down to the ground. You feel really, again, same kind of thing as Abar. You feel cold. You feel start to feel a little disoriented. You're not sure what direction to go. It hasn't quite started to, you know, hurting you in any way, the cold, but you're feeling it. Okay?
Okay.
All right. So, Carhu.
Okay. So you mentioned that the sun, is it dark then, since we don't see the sun, or is it?
Yeah, it's always, like, almost perpetually dark, even during the day.
Okay.
Not like, you know, it's like dim.
Can I see the people around me?
All right, do a perception check. Let's see, what was your strength? Your strength check was...
I rolled a 17 on my strength
okay.
check.
Okay, all right. And perception, 13. Okay. Same thing as Yarzu. You thought you saw the fleeting image of a figure struggling in the snow, but it kind of went away after a moment. Okay. But same kind of thing. You thought you saw something.
Okay. Can I attempt to sort of get my bearings and figure out, like, where I am and my surroundings with, sure. like, a survival?
Yeah, you can do a survival check. Yep.
Yeesh. Not great.
10? Okay, yeah. You don't quite know which way to go. The only thing you saw was just that fleeting image of a person.
Okay. Well, I'll just walk in the direction of the person.
Okay.
Where was it?
You're going to move. You're going to be... it's going to be difficult terrain. So the direction is this way.
Did you say this way?
No. Oh, right. You're...
I was looking at my other...
No, right here. Right here.
Okay, I'll just walk that way.
Okay. All right,
and I'll
so,
step on top of Chamberlain.
Well, yeah, Chamberlain. Let's see. Chamberlain, what was your status? You were...
I had an 18.
Oh, you were good. Okay, so you see something coming towards you out of the snow. And Carhu, you are approaching someone who's struggling through the snow.
Hello? Hello? Hello! It's windy.
It's very cold and windy.
I'm gonna cast. Here, hold on. I'm gonna cast Thaumaturgy, and okay. I'm gonna raise my voice 3 times as loud as normal.
Oh, nice.
So that way I can.
An avalanche falls.
Hello.
Well, actually, no. I'm just kidding. I'm glad you mentioned that. I'm just kidding.
What do you look like?
I'm just at right now. I'm just in standard, like,
just
cold
snow.
Weather clothing.
Yeah, you really
just standard cold weather clothing with right. like a decently long beard, like down maybe like to the top of my stomach. And it's just all crusted with snow at this point because it's blowing everywhere.
Okay.
And just a quarterstaff and maybe like a backpack
okay.
that you can maybe see. I don't know.
Right.
But yeah, I just look like a wandering beggar sickle.
Okay, so like your portrait, is that what you look like?
No,
face-wise?
That was
no,
not at all.
No, no, okay. And that's a comment that I was going to mention. That's one common thing in Icewind Dale. You know that people garment themselves up for the winter, so it's really difficult to recognize people in general unless they wear specific clothing.
Face and hat go. Think of like a Radagast, but younger, like a lot younger.
Okay.
Like just kind of disheveled, really squalorly, like really poor looking.
Okay.
Yeah.
It looks pretty much like my portrait, except I'm draped in winter trappings as well, and a big polar bear cloak.
Oh.
You know, with the head helmet.
Nice
you
and
know.
Warm.
Yeah.
I live here, so. Well, I don't know where I am, but I assume I live here. so we could be anywhere. But, okay. So I'll come trudging up to you, and I'll look and just say, hey, oh. Well, not old man, but. And you, what did you say?
Hello, who are you?
I look shocked, and I kneel down, and I have one hand on one of my hand axes, and I kind of kneel before you, and I say, is that you, Lord Tempest? Is this my time?
No.
Because basically, like, your voice was really loud, right? Like
right.
Unnaturally
godlike.
Loud. Godlike. So I assume that I've died, and now Tempest is guiding me.
Calling you home.
Yep, through the snow, so.
Yeah, no, I am not Tempest. I'm just a wanderer. I'm trying to get back to Ten Towns. It's cold, and it's blowing like crazy, and there's snow everywhere, and I can't see.
It's cold, and this blows.
I'm a little lost.
Oh, forgive me, your voice. It's so strong for one of such small stature.
It's loud out here, so I amplified it with magic, just so that way I can get my point across to you, but I now understand that I don't need to do that.
Magic?
Yeah, magic.
Yes, granted by Ilmater. I am a servant of Ilmater.
Ah, I see. Then you are a shaman, then.
Not really, but you a traveling healer.
You work for the benefit of your god.
Yes.
You are not a wizard.
No.
Good.
Very divine. Well, very
then
divine.
I will help you out of the snow.
Okay. All right.
If you want, I'll reach down and kind of stabilize both of us.
I'm good, dude. I rolled an 18. I'm stable. I'm just cold.
I will warm you up. No.
Thank you.
Come here.
No, and then I'm just joining up with you, so we don't.
Yeah, let's go find the town because I don't want to be cold anymore.
Okay. All right. Let's go to Mecca.
Maybe somebody else heard you.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Let's go to Mecca. What are you doing? You rolled. Were you prone?
I was not.
Right, that's right. You were still struggling along.
Correct.
But it was very cold. Same thing. You're very cold. You're starting to get kind of disoriented, but you're still able to move. What are you going to do?
Again, have I seen anybody? Have I seen anything that did I see the other two characters at all?
Do a perception check. Mecca, mecca, hi, mecca, hidey, ho. That's what Himble said. That's funny.
Okay,
yes, see. Angel Beetslin, that would be a very quick TPK, but I can't do that to him right now.
All right. So I'm just rolling up here, and I get a plus one.
Ooh, nice. Okay. 17. Okay. Same thing. You think you see some... a figure walking through the snow, struggling along. And I think Yarzo actually... he dropped out. He's not in this chat anymore. But anyways, he like fell on the ground and was trying to get going. So, but yeah, you do see... it's this direction. You saw somebody.
Okay. I head that direction.
Okay. All right, go ahead and move. All right, now Yarzu's not in. Dropped off on the camera. Did anybody get a message from him? Or
mm-mm. I'll see.
See where he is. Okay.
I was gonna say too. She probably heard me if I'm yelling at three times my normal voice.
Maybe she was a little distance. She was a little distance away. She's closer to Yarzo. But you can do another perception check. That's a good call. Okay. See if maybe you heard something in the wind.
I get a plus one.
Oh, 20. Geez, 20. Okay. So, yeah, you also think you heard something from over in this direction.
It's Saruman!
Yeah, because he amplified his voice, so you just heard it on the wind. What did you say, Chamberlain, when you did your thaumaturgy?
Hi, who are you?
Okay. All right. So, yeah, so you heard that in the wind, and you think you have a pretty good idea of what direction it came from, so over this way. And if Yarzu's back on, we'll come back to...
Shall not pass!
Nice. Okay. That is... If the characters or the players don't know, but we have a bits thing hooked up, sound effects on the feed, so people can do bits to do different things. So, like, if a character gets killed, there's a song that they can play. A monster gets killed, something like that, but... So, yeah. Yeah, it played. That was Mama Thunder did that, too, just to see what it would do. So, so maybe you heard that.
Hey, guys, I just dropped out. What did I miss?
Oh, no problem. Okay, we'll come back to you. We were going a little bit ahead, but we'll come back to you. So, basically, this person right here came walking up to you in the snow as you were trying to get up and struggle along. You see her... This large person, because you can't really tell. She's all bundled up like everybody is, so it's hard to tell. But she's very tall, very, very large, you know, this person.
She helping me up, or she just came up to me?
What are you doing, Mecca? Yes. You guys have to role play this out.
She's pushing you further into the snow.
One hand.
Yes, I'm helping him up.
Okay. What do you do, Yarzo?
I accept the help. I say thank you. I probably wouldn't have made it out without you. I appreciate the help.
What are you doing out here?
I was on my way back, searching some ruins nearby, and the blizzard caught me off guard. I don't know where the people I came with. I don't even know who the people are, really. I went with a group that was going to search the ruins, and I don't know where they are now. This blizzard just screwed up everything.
I see. Well, there is safety in numbers. Do you want to travel together?
Absolutely.
I thought I heard something just up ahead of us. I heard something in the wind.
Well, let's go look.
Okay. Okay, so you can move if you like.
Is it nighttime or daytime? It's probably daytime, right?
It's daytime, but as I said, it's very dark because of what we were talking about earlier, the constant darkness.
Okay.
Like, when you mean darkness, do you mean, like, just the sun's behind the storm clouds, so it's always, like...
It perpetually, yeah.
Okay, but it's not, like, outright no source of light whatsoever.
It's right, okay. Correct. Because this is daytime, but it's like day-ish.
Day-ish.
Kurt, can I cast light on the end of my quarterstaff?
Sure. Do whatever you like.
Cantrip.
Mm-hmm. Do whatever you like.
Should I put that in the...
Yeah, go ahead. That's perfect. Yeah, light.
To hopefully help us be able to see a little bit better. I don't know how it's going to do with the blizzard, but...
Okay. What is the object that you're touching?
My quarterstaff.
Your quarterstaff. Okay, you did say that. Okay. So, bright light, 20-foot radius. Dim light, another 20 feet. Okay. So, Chamberlain, make a perception check. Well, Karhu's not there right now. So, Chamberlain, make a perception check.
An 18.
Okay, cool. So, you see... a little distance away from you, approaching, as you see this light, and you can see it through the blizzard as it blows around, and you see two figures approaching.
In a very loud voice, I go, "Hello!" more people out here in this mess. This is terrible. I mean, it's fortunate that we found each other, but this is terrible.
Come join us. Let's find a way out of this mess.
Yeah, I have someone else here, too. He's right here. I don't think we actually introduced each other. But yes, he's here, and he'll come with us, too, probably, because it's cold.
And you all look trustworthy, right?
You look trustworthy. Join our party.
I can't see you underneath your winter clothing, but I think we trust each other.
Please take off your winter clothing so we can see what you look like.
No.
I'm gonna turn to the great white wall of blowing snow and be like, "Is there anyone else out there?"
Okay. You did that? Did you do that with your thaumaturgy or just yelling?
Oh yeah, it's still going.
It's still going. Okay, Himball, make a perception check. And I guess Barris can also. Barris, make a perception check. Barris is just like all alone. Himball, 10. Okay, Chamberlain, or no, Barris. Barris, I'm sorry.
Apparently not. There's nobody else here.
Yeah, Himble, you didn't hear anything. Barris, you didn't hear anything. So, all right. So you guys are now all hooked up together, all four of you. So let's go. Well, Carhu, we'll come back to him. Chamberlain, we're all good. Mecca, okay. Himble.
All right.
Where were you at? Were you prone or were you good?
No, I rolled a 14, so yeah, you were good.
You're good. Okay.
So I'm going to take out a torch and light this mess.
Okay.
To get a little bit of warmth around me. Does it even work?
You're going to try to light a torch?
I'm going to try.
Okay. You try to light a torch and you just cannot get it lit. The snow is just blowing so hard and you just can't get it lit. It's very cold. And yeah.
Okay. Well, then I'm going to look around and if I've been around here, I've basically lost all sense of direction due to the storm, correct?
Correct.
So would it be maybe a knowledge nature or perception to try to find my way through this thing?
It would be a survival check.
Survival.
Survival. Okay.
Yeah, be a survival.
Hey, that's even better.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh.
10. Okay. Yeah, you don't know if you're going the right direction or not, but you are able to move. It's difficult terrain. I'm not going to have you move. Well, yeah, I'm not going to have you move any certain direction at this point.
Can I roll also a perception to see if I see anything?
Yes.
Hey.
Boop. Nice. 20. Okay. So as you look about, you think you caught the glimpse of some light this direction. Just a fleeting moment of light and a little break in the storm.
Okay. I gotta look up my dog, because I have his speed.
Okay.
I think it's 30.
30, yeah, it's probably 30. So go ahead and you'll be... Obviously, it's difficult terrain, so you can move 15 feet.
And there's no... okay. So then... The squares are even hard to see.
Yeah, they are.
One, two, three.
You can do a range finder if you want. It'll...
Oh, no, I'm good.
Okay.
I mean, I can see it. It's just...
Yeah.
You should take my time.
All right, so you're moving forward. Are you doing anything else?
Nope. I tried to start a torch. I looked around. I tried to find my direction. And I got to move. I think that's pretty much all I
saw
can
some,
do.
And you saw some potential.
I saw a light.
A light.
I want to be in the light.
Light. Got it. All right. So let's go to Barris. We're back to Barris here.
Barris.
Okay. I want to...
took a while, but we got to Barris.
See if we can do like a survival check or something of that nature to see... which direction I may believe
you're supposed to go.
The town is.
Okay, survival check. Nice. Natural 20. Just saved your life. Okay, so you can move, and you are moving in the direction, which would be this direction.
Okay.
Just going towards 10 towns, and you can move. It is still difficult terrain, but you can... You're pretty confident that you know the direction to go.
Okay. Diagonal squares, they count as two for the first one?
Nope.
No.
Just normal?
Yeah.
Yep.
5e rules.
So I'll move to there.
Okay, so you get to there, and then you see just a little bit in front of you, through the blowing wind, you see a shape walking. A short shape. Very short. Looks like a child walking through the snow.
Looks like a child walking through the snow?
Yeah, child walking through the snow.
I'm going to cautiously have my hand on my sword.
Actually,
as I'm unsure, and see if I can perceive any details.
Yeah, you can tell them how you look. You are covered up in your winter gear, but you can...
That is true, but my winter gear is so big that I like to consider it so long that I can actually kind of cover my dog.
Okay.
So in a sense, it actually kind of looks like I'm actually... On top of my dog, I would be about as tall as a normal dude.
Oh, gotcha.
You're probably the height of a dwarf.
Or a dwarf, yeah, exactly.
About 4 feet, yeah.
But I have like a really, you know, it's like a, almost like a tent, so I'm just like...
You see this walking tent.
Yeah, that's not suspicious.
You found shelter.
You found shelter.
All right, cautiously with my hand on my sword, I yell out, "Halt! Who goes there?"
Do I hear that?
Yes. Oh, wait. Do a perception. It's still blowing really hard, but you shouldn't have a problem, but still do a perception. If you rolled like a one or something, then something low. Okay, yeah, you're good. So you did hear that, and you do see this figure approaching.
So knowing my background, do I maybe know him by his face, if I can see his face?
You can't see his face. I'm sure he has his face covered up.
What? Oh, sorry. I'm kind of loud, huh? Hey, is there someone out there? It's a little hard to see due to all the snow.
So, Barris, you are able to hear that?
Okay. I reply back as loudly as possible. I am Barris, captain of 10 towns. Stop where you're at.
Is this your jurisdiction? I mean, yeah, sure.
is this your jurisdiction?
Can I see a badge?
I'm Sir Dorkslayer. You might have heard of me if you're from anywhere from Tenstown. I'm a pretty big deal. I mean, I'm a little deal, but you know what I mean.
Would I have heard of him before?
Do a knowledge check, yeah.
What knowledge?
Insight?
No. What you got?
History, maybe?
Investigation? No, I don't know. History probably would be better.
Out of those, that'd probably be better. Because he was trying to proclaim himself as somebody well-known. So that's like history.
History.
Oh, you've never heard of him.
Nope.
Must not that be big of a folk hero.
You haven't heard of him, but you think maybe he was on a most wanted list. You're not sure.
What?
Sure, you know, Jane.
All right.
Just stay there and don't move. And I'll when I get another available turn, I'll move closer towards him.
Okay.
With caution.
All right.
You just wait for my next turn.
Do a perception, because the wind's blowing. You guys did see...
11.
Okay. You didn't hear anything, and the wind's blowing too hard. Okay, so let's head back over to Abar. You were having a little problem over there, laying on the ground, prone. Let's get you going here.
Can I roll perception to see if I've heard any of the stuff that has gone on?
The elephant laying down.
You can try, but you gotta do it at a disadvantage.
Can we talk about the elephant in the room right now?
He's not in the room.
No, he's not. He's not here yet.
He's buried in a snowdrift.
Elephant in the map.
Wow.
Woo.
Ooh, you pursue.
So a 19. Wow. Talk about a total luck out. All right. So
I'm a monk. Wisdom is my high stat.
Right.
He can't stand for shit in the snow, but he can hear it.
Okay, so you thought you heard somebody yelling, and it sounded very official, but you caught some glimpses of some words in the air. Something about stop right there.
Okay, so
that's
I can
basically
hear him?
All you heard. Yeah, you just heard a glimpse of it, and you have a pretty good idea of the direction, too.
Okay.
Those are really good rolls for disadvantage.
I am going to...
19 and 21.
I'm going to awesome. Try to stand up again.
Okay, do it. Strength check. Hey, we're almost there, people. We've almost brought the party together.
I was going to say, can I do an athletics to try to do like a push-up out of it?
Sure.
Athletics is better than just my straight strength, so.
What? There you go.
Ooh, yeah.
Good job.
Yeah, but you said with this, I'm assuming with disadvantage, right?
Yeah.
Okay, then let me throw another
more
one.
20. Okay.
Yep, there we go.
You try to push yourself up, and you just fall back down, but you did hear something.
Okay, then with that, as I struggle to get up and I fall back down,
yes.
I just yell out the loudest yell I can.
Got it. Good idea. Barris, Himbal, make perception checks. And Marcus, are you with us?
Yo.
Oh, you're with us.
Hey.
You got black screen.
Black screen of death.
Sorry, my webcam's like not working right now, so
okay.
I've been trying to fix it for like the past 30 minutes, and then I went down to Best Buy, and I'm like, nope, okay. I guess I'm going black screen.
No problem. And you're Mark, dude. I noticed that. So you're Mark up there in the corner. You're kind of looking off into the distance.
Yeah.
You're staring into the void.
I am Marcus the Red.
Okay, so Barris, Himdall. Oh, Himdall already did his perception. 13. Okay, Barris.
Hey, Rick.
Barris.
Yes, you ring.
Barris.
Perception.
Perception check.
Perception.
Perceive. Oh, I perceived. I perceived
perceive
that field goal. Get kicked. Oh. Wrong game. My bad. Nope.
Oh. Didn't hear anything.
I'm too focused on the individual that's in front of me and too leery of that.
That's true. That's true. Okay. All right. So, anything else, Ebar? That's it, right?
Let's see. Tried to get up.
Tried to get up. Yelled.
Yelled.
In the snow. Wow.
Can he crawl? Can he crawl?
Whatever you want to try to do.
I'm thinking that the logistics of that would be much more difficult than even just trying to get up. Because you're basically having to burrow through the snow.
You could.
It's fair.
I mean, I'll attempt it.
I mean, you can always use your trunk as like a snorkel. You're just like
the breathing is not the issue. It's the fact that I'm going to freeze to death. Because
I mean, it's going to be an issue eventually. At this rate.
Okay. Yeah. I'll attempt to move. I'll
okay.
attempt to kind of crawl.
Okay.
Towards
gonna,
where I heard the sound.
I'm going to have you do a survival check.
Okay.
Survive.
Let's see if you can survive. If any time you need a 20, is now when you need it. 13.
13.
Okay. You're able to crawl a little bit, but you don't have a real good idea of your direction. So you can move, like, yeah. Okay. That's fine. All right. Well, that's pretty much it. Marcus. Let's go to Marcus next. You need to make a strength check first, then do a perception check. Okay, good. So you're good. The snow's
yeah.
blowing really hard. It doesn't knock you down, but it's just really bitterly cold, and you do feel it. And so make a, perception check next.
Perception check next, yes.
Yep. Okay, no. 18. Jeez. Nice. Okay, so you think in the distance here, or somewhere close to you, you think you saw a figure or the snow moving. Of course, this is all happening very quickly, all this round. So you think you saw something fall into the snow and kind of move around in the snow. It's just a short distance away from you. You just caught a fleeting glimpse of it. And it's this
Marcus just coming in and saving the day with his
distraction. Isn't that funny? So close.
Gotta keep it the namesake.
So
typical
close.
Mark fashion.
So. Yeah.
Let me check and see what I can do here.
And you need to... Well, no, go ahead. Tell me what you're going to do.
So what terrain are we in again? This is very
tundra.
Arctic, it's tundra. Not Arctic.
No.
Okay.
It is Icewind Dale. It's very kind of darkish and windy and blizzardly right now.
Okay. Definitely chose the wrong terrain then.
Did you take the desert?
Yeah. Damn it, I took desert. I thought it was going to be one of those trick campaigns. No, I chose Arctic.
The mist descends.
Yes. Ooh, don't tempt me.
Okay.
October is next month.
Icewind Dale. Icewind Dale Ravenloft Edition.
What kind of a check would it be to kind of try and pull and dig my way from here over to... over yonder towards where the noise was.
You just need to do a survival check.
Survival check.
Yep. Okay. You're able to trudge towards the snow that direction.
Half speed or full speed?
It's difficult terrain, so it's half speed.
Half speed. Okay, gotcha. Okay, so it's going to be 5, 10, 15.
Okay.
Arms outstretched, ready to grab either whatever I saw moving in these Arctic gales. And if for some reason I can't get a hold of it, I will at least cling on to my my large tusked friend
and cling on.
Hopefully help him get up.
Cling on, yeah.
Make sure you ask for permission. You didn't just like be crabby all the time.
You can just keep grabbing tusks. Yeah, that's why I'm not allowed in Luskin anymore.
Trunks.
Yeah. Oh. He got kicked out of Luskin.
Stroking too many trunks. But when I move over here,
you do see a large person.
I see the large elephant. Did I happen to see what was moving in this area?
That's what you think was moving there.
Okay.
Yeah.
In that case, I will grab onto him, and with my measly strength of 11, I will try and
pull him out of the
very
snow?
Futilely try and help him up. But okay. I'll do that next turn.
Okay. All right. So back to the other party, other group over here. Group number one. Yarzo, Mecca, Chamberlain, and Karhu. What are you all doing? You've all kind of gathered together.
I'm going in for a hug with Karhu. Just, I was like, hey, friend.
Bring it in.
I don't know that he doesn't like wizards. But
you don't know that.
He doesn't know you're a wizard, so.
Probably gives it away, though, with the light on the end of my staff.
Yeah, that's true.
Start moving.
Neat torch.
That torch isn't going out.
I'm gonna turn to the other three people and be like, "Do you guys remember which way it is to Ten Towns? I don't know where I am at the moment.
I don't either. This blizzard got me all disoriented. If only we had like a city guard captain or something that knew the area.
Someone to ask.
Known he's an inevitable.
For the first time, noticed this beautiful woman. Who is that? Hello. I look up. Wow.
She's very tall.
All I picture is the redheaded guy from Game of Thrones.
Under all his furry, you can tell if you hate him.
Oh, I can tell.
He doesn't care.
It's cold.
It's cold. Doesn't matter. Okay, so.
Can I get a perception check? You see if I can tell which way we should go.
Yeah, and you actually get advantage with the roll, because you're kind of used to this terrain. And the everybody else can assist if they wish to see which way to go.
What?
Survival. Survival.
Survival.
Survival.
Yep.
Survival. Hey, Kurt, I don't see Tundra on Natural Explorer for, like, terrain that we can choose.
What do you have on there?
Under Natural Explorer, it says we can choose Arctic, Coast, Desert, okay. Forest, Grassland, Mountain, Swamp, or Underdark.
Arctic would be good. It's fine.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Because this is your the area that you're in. It's like it's very Arctic.
I'll see my dice.
Okay.
Oh, you're there. You rolled a 18?
No, you rolled a 6 and a 12.
6 and a 12, yeah.
Plus 3?
Oh, so 15
is your highest.
15, yeah. Okay, good.
I can't figure out how to get the extension.
No, yeah. We'll take care of that later.
I rolled a natural 20. I got a 22.
Ooh, okay, so it looks like between all of you there, you kind of all know as a group which way to go. You're very confident that you now see the trail to 10 towns.
You talking about the four of us?
Yeah, the group of four.
Well, since there's nobody else out here because I yelled out and nobody responded, we should head back to town.
I agree. We've got a good size adventuring party with four of us.
Yeah.
Let's go ahead and move on.
Oh my God.
Yeah, let's do
perfect.
It. This is perfect.
You kind of wish we had an elephant that we could ride.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
I also kind of wish we had a kind of NPC person we could drag along with us that could pop in at the right time every single time.
Yeah, there you go.
And a city guard still. That'd be really nice.
Yeah, it's always good to know the city guard. Okay.
Oh, and the guy with the dog shoe, too, sure. Why not?
The guy that rides the dog. If I almost saw a guy that was riding a dog, that would be great.
I'll consider a lovable scamp.
Hmm?
Comic relief.
Yeah. Okay, so Marcus, yes, I saw your deal in the chat there, and you are correct. So we'll go over to you next after we deal. Okay, so group number one, you're on your way back to 10 towns, correct? Okay.
See.
In particular, you know from your survival checks, you are closest to the town of Goodmead.
Oh, I hope it's named for what it's called.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Goodmead. Okay.
All right.
So you guys are basically traveling separate from these guys unless something else happens. So we're going to move you. I'm assuming you're moving. It's still difficult terrain.
This is weird. I smell somebody over here. That's so weird. Hey. Hey, I found four more people.
No, you didn't. Get over here, Karu. All right. You felt this hand, grab you, and you get drugged through the snow. What's happening?
I saw a skeleton of a woolly mammoth. It will be priceless in a museum.
Okay. I must have been imagining it.
All right, so you guys are headed to, group number one's headed to Goodmead. And so we'll come back to you later. You're going to travel on, and yeah,
terrible.
You shouldn't
terrible
have any more bombs. I like it. Triple split party. It's awesome. All right, let's go to Himble and Barris. What's happening over there?
I yell out. Is it weird to get like? Did the town all of a sudden develop a stop and frisk policy? Are we going to do this out here in the blizzard?
You pulled me over for no reason.
Yeah. I have a busted like taillight.
A busted taillight. You weren't wearing your mittens.
All of a sudden, I throw something outside of the window and left. Get it out of here.
I ask, which town are you heading to?
Tenzin. Or Tenstown. Sorry.
Ten towns.
Watch a lot of Avatar.
Ten towns.
But in particular, you're heading. In particular, you're heading towards Goodmead.
Yeah. What the voice said.
The voice from in the wind. You're going to Goodmead.
Yeah, that's so that's down on way to Goodmead.
That's not railroading.
Well, if you need the company, we can accompany each other there. Just be sure to
keep your hands where you can see them. Keep your hands where you can see them.
Sure. Do you want some ropes just in case we get lost?
No, I'll be fine.
Okay. I stay close to him. I let him catch up, and then we keep walking together.
Okay, so Barris, one thing you know when he starts taking off walking, he seems to have more legs than just two.
He's an abomination.
Nature check?
Nature check? Sure.
Less than four?
You rolled a one.
I'm just confused.
Oh my god.
You have no idea what it is.
I make a mental note.
It's very strange. It's very strange looking, though. So
I made a millionaire when I get that.
That does make you extra suspicious, though, because there's all kinds of. There are strange creatures out in the Icewind Dale area. Okay, so you guys are traveling.
I once saw a talking mammoth.
A talking elephant.
Yeah,
a sloth and a talking saber-toothed tiger.
I once rode a talking elephant.
That's ridiculous.
Okay, so you guys are traveling along together, and you're going to make your way to Goodsmead. That's party number two. Party number three. Marcus and Adlar, what are you doing?
Attempt to stand up.
Okay, he's helping you. He is assisting you. So between the two of you, please make a roll. Strength check?
Okay.
Between the two of you, both of you.
Oh, do I have to roll my separate, or do I give him assist because I'm helping him?
Well, you can give him an assist, yeah. Okay. Oh, Abar. My gosh.
You made it worse.
Oh, man. Okay, oh, man. Marcus, do it. He just fell back down. He looks in bad shape. Yeah. Oh, my gosh. You tried to pick him up, but he's so heavy. He just falls back in the snow. You guys are starting to feel desperation kind of come on because the snow and cold is really starting to get to you. I need to know what you guys want to do, what you both want to do.
I'm sorry. I thought I trained for this.
Level one.
Well... Marcus, you do feel that you can move pretty quickly through the snow. You feel like you have some skills in doing that. And you're pretty confident you know the direction to go. I don't know how you feel about this person that you found, so.
Right. Do I not consider them my quote-unquote party yet?
No. You just found this person dying in the snow.
So they won't benefit from Natural Explorer, because otherwise... We would all be good, but we just met.
Himble. Yeah. What was that
I
for?
I will.
Walk this way.
Oh, gosh.
What you gonna do? It's a quandary.
Shit. I don't want to leave this guy to die either.
Can I make one more attempt?
Well, let's see what Marcus is going to do first, and then.
Oh, I'll use one of my lucky points because I took the feat lucky, so I'll use one of my points to reroll that d20.
Okay. To try to help him up.
Attack roll, ability check, or saving throw. Would this be an ability check roll that I just did?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I'll try one more time.
You're doing strength check, yeah. Oh my gosh.
I rolled a one. Sorry, I just wanted to grab onto your trunk again.
Albar, Albar's really having a tough time here, people.
Where's your crown?
Hey, out there in the chat. Can we get
some divine intervention in here?
Hey, people in the chat, let's give him some help here. Come on. What?
5 subs equals 1 reroll.
5 subs equals 1 reroll. Well, there is a dice roller on the thing too. You can actually roll the dice. Roll the dice and get a good roll. And if you want to do it, now's the time. Spend some bits and make a roll on the bit roller. It'll show up in the chat. And you maybe save Abar's life. Yeah, you can.
Let me donate to my own. Let me donate to the own stream.
Yeah, why not? It's where the audience can participate. That's how we do it. Save his life. Nobody's doing it yet. Nobody's doing it. They're all going, what?
No, they're just like, let him die.
Oh, yeah. Man, that's harsh.
What if they give the reroll to the DM, though?
Well, they can roll.
Can you force a reroll for the DM? That'd be good.
Wow, it's not now. Yeah, no.
Later on.
Yeah, maybe later. Okay, well, anyway, so where were we at? So, Marcus, what are you doing?
I had used my point of luck to do a reroll.
Okay.
It got worse.
That's a no action ability. I did a strength check to help get him up. I'm gonna start digging through my equipment, and I'm gonna start getting out a length of rope, and I'm gonna start tying that around Abar's tusks.
Okay.
One of his tests, and I'll say, hold on, we'll get you out of here.
I forgot that I rolled a 13 perception when Abar yelled out. Did I hear that?
No.
Oh, okay, never mind then.
Was it a yell or a trumpet?
No, it was a yell.
It was a yell. All right. So you're going to get some rope out, put it around him, try to what?
I'm just trying to secure rope around him. I'm gonna try and secure some rope around his tusks.
Okay.
So that way he can lead him back to when I'm dead.
We just want that ivory.
And hopefully start taking the rope in a this way direction eventually.
Okay.
Do you need a roll for me to tie some rope around his tusks?
No, you can do that easily enough.
Okay, gotcha. So, yeah, I'll do that, and then
you try to pull him. Or what are you doing now?
Yeah, I'll try and pull him out using like the rope as a little bit of a get a better handling because I imagine you're a Luxodon with very shiny sleek tusks.
Delicious tusks.
You were trying to, and with the thing on the strength is you were just trying to help him up so he could walk on his own. So now what you're trying to do is you're trying to drag him or pull him through the snow. Okay.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Good. All right. So you can easily tie the rope around him. Are you doing anything else?
If I'm able to this turn, I'll try pulling him.
Yeah, it's all up to you guys now. The other parties are on their way to Goodmead, so.
Gotcha.
Okay. I'm going to allow Abar to also do a strength check with the disadvantage to try to push with your feet or something like that, because you just can't stand up for some reason. But
strength or athletics?
Strength. Well, no, I'll give you athletics. I'll give you athletics. Okay. Yeah.
Did the first one roll?
No, you rolled an 8.
Okay. Well, I was gonna say I because I can't see it from my screen.
Right.
Until I switch over. So.
Right. Yeah, you rolled an 8 and an 11. Okay, well, he's trying to push his feet, and it's just sliding on the ice as you're trying to pull him. So, Marcus, it's all up to you.
Oh, I rolled a 2 on the die.
Oh, man.
Well,
you try to pull him.
Characters, everybody.
I forgot this is the buttered rope.
Trying to pull him. Okay,
trying to pull up a wet elephant.
It's hard to grab a rope because you don't have hands. You just have those flat feet.
I got hands.
It's okay. It's okay, Angel Beetslin. No problem.
He's got seven pairs of severed hands around his neck.
Angel Beetle said, I don't have bits, Kurt. I'm sorry. No problem. It's no problem. They got to work this out on their own. Okay, so Marcus, what are you doing? What can you do here, buddy?
Tried to cheese it. He wouldn't let me.
Well, I assisted him with his check to get up. I tied rope around his tusks, and then I did my own strength check to pull him out. Am I able to do anything else?
You can. That's up to you.
I will start walking my speed, holding the rope in this direction.
Okay. Now you can move normally because of your ability.
Okay, so when I get to here, do I see Barriss and Heimdall?
Yeah, considering all this is happening simultaneously, they did walk a little distance, so we're going to, basically what we're going to do at this point, this will kind of be the final chance to do this to try to save him. So, and then you're going to have to think of something else. But they're going to roll perception checks. You're going to roll a perception check. And let's see what happens. Let's see if you guys see each other.
Okay. Let's see if I see you. Or if I'm blind.
Everybody keep your fingers crossed. Everybody keep your fingers crossed. Marcus rolled a 7.
I rolled a 1 on the die, a 2 on the die, and now I'm at a 3 on the die.
You don't see anything. You're very confident of your direction to get to town, and you can actually move, because of your ability, you can actually move normal speed. So you're not, and you know you're not too far from town. That's one thing you do know. Yeah, so just keep that in mind. 10, 15,
20, 25, 30. That would be my full speed right there at speed 30.
Okay, Himble, Barriss, make perception checks. See what happens.
I feel like Marcus is going to just look back at the rope. He can't see the other end. He's going, I'm sorry. Keeps
going. That's what it's coming to. I tried.
He was so young.
Barriss, 21. Himble. I keep saying Himble. Himble, what'd you get? 21 and 21.
Also a 21.
Okay. 21. You see,
great minds travel together.
Now,
yeah, but also I got a natural 20 for that 21.
Nice. Okay. Oh. Well, you may have just saved Abar's life here. Marcus, you don't see them, but so Himble and Abar. Rebar. No, Abar.
Babar.
Babar, yeah.
Babar the elephant.
Oh,
so, I got part of the name from.
So Marcus,
I too support colonialism. Which is weird for a barbarian.
I'm a
barbarian.
So Marcus, you don't see them. You're blinded by the snow, but you're still hanging on to that rope. And you're trudging your way through the snow.
Yeah, I got the rope over my shoulder, and I'm just trudging as far as the rope will take me, hoping that I'll see like something or someone. Right. I can't see them, so I'm none the wiser.
So Himble, Barriss, you see this guy with a rope over his shoulder walk past you.
Hey, look at that guy. Are you going to hold him up too?
Stop! Hold there!
That bounce on him! As you get him, I'm running away like, bye!
my first enemy.
No.
Okay, so what do you guys do?
What are you dragging?
There's someone stuck in the snow.
Dragon. He said drag. He said he
I heard dragon.
He said dragon. He didn't say dragging. He said dragon. That's what you heard.
Wait, dragon?
You said dragon. What are you dragging?
No, what are you dragging? Like,
what are you, a dragon?
No. All they heard in the snow, though, is dragon.
Oh, someone needs help.
I am dragging this beast behind me.
By Torm's beard, I'll help. Or Grace, we'll say Torm's Grace. So I'll follow the rope back and start heading that direction.
Okay. Barriss.
Help me pull it.
Barriss, what are you doing?
I'll assist Marcus in pulling.
Okay.
Did we make it to the meat hall yet?
I know. This is a...
I heard there's a Starbucks up here.
Oh, oh dear.
Okay.
Hello.
So Himbo,
you look like you need some help.
So we have the biggest creature and the smallest guy.
Yep.
That's okay. So I'm going to tie up another rope around him, but I'm going to tie this end to the collar of my trusty steed Cooper, and we're gonna try to get him. We're gonna have two ropes basically.
Dragging him
along.
All right. Do it.
So can a Saint Bernard lift a elephant?
He's a husky, you know. Well, he's a like a big Saint Bernard, not a husky.
Okay.
Anyway,
so Barris, what were you doing? Oh, Barris, you were
also.
On
do you
the
need a drink?
Too?
I have warm vodka in this little thing on his neck.
You have warm vodka.
Warm That's vodka.
Not that it keeps you warm.
Vodka doesn't keep you warm.
Say that.
Shut up.
Giving
out free
vodka.
Make you think you're warm. Makes you think you're warm.
You're not. You're still dying.
All right. It's called hypothermia. Okay. Right, okay. Strength checks.
How are we gonna do this? I need strength
checks. Do
just
it.
The highest out of the three.
Well, we're gonna see how they play out here.
Okay.
21.
That's good. That's nice.
17.
That's good too.
I'm
Himble.
Nope, my computer hates me.
Abar, you just want to die, man.
No, I don't.
Google intervention.
Google intervention. Oh, my gosh. Oh, man.
My computer just hates me.
You need some more. You need some new virtual dice.
No, it doesn't matter. They're all bad.
Okay, so Himble. Okay, what did you roll?
Oh,
you got a 17. Barris got a...
21.
Okay. Marcus, roll.
15. Got a 15.
Nice. Okay.
I got it.
So you feel like you are able to drag him.
Yeah.
You are dragging him through the snow.
Dragon.
Yeah.
At this point of a bar, you should just like stop moving and just accept your fate as you're going to be dragged.
Yeah, he basically. That's exactly what he has to do. He's under basically level one exhaustion at this point.
Oh.
He's feeling very cold, and he's just being dragged through the snow. So we'll figure out that as we go. You guys are making good progress. You got basically three people dragging him, so you can move pretty quickly. You can't quite move as fast as Marcus, because Marcus seems to know his way very well in this terrain, but the rest of you know the direction to go to, so you can make decent progress.
Okay.
So basically normal progress with Marcus, Marcus leading the way, so.
Cool.
Okay.
Along our way, can I also try to keep an eye out for maybe any, large branches or something that we can makeshift, a body cart for the elephant. Just trying to plan ahead here, okay?
Yeah, you can do that, definitely. There's going to be some trees and stuff like that as you go, especially as you get closer to 10 towns.
Your smallest character remark got the second highest strength score, so...
Elephant son. That's the elephant in the room.
But I'm only strong because of Torn.
Got it.
All right.
So you guys are able to make your way.
Yay, we did it.
Wow.
Go BC.
I did not think you were going to do it.
2 hours later.
2 hours later. Hey, but I think that was pretty exciting for the... Yeah, Angel Beatsland said the dice are weighted. Your virtual dice are weighted.
Yeah.
Yeah. So viewers out there, that was pretty nail-biting. At least it had some excitement. They didn't have to fight anything, but they fought the weather. So that's a big part of Icewind Dale. It gives you kind of a good introduction to Icewind Dale, especially at its current state. So, all right. So you guys are. Let me cut the blizzard here. All right, blizzard done. Not over, but it's done for now.
Yeah.
Whew. Wow. Okay. So you guys are going to continue on to Icewind Dale.
And
to
the town of Bad Beer, right?
Yeah. Bad beer.
Good.
No, good mead.
Good mead. Okay. Yeah, good mead.
That's why the beer's bad.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's see where we're at here. Good mead.
It's kind of like how most of us, or we used to all live in Bakersfield, but now everyone, but the other, otherwise they'd known it as Oildale.
yeah, exactly. Okay, so you make your way to Good Mead. Let me see if I can get you over there real quick. We're getting, yeah, we can go a little bit longer. At least get you started into Good Mead.
Tavern scene.
No tavern scene.
If you hated John's comment about Oildale, donate 100 bits right now.
Yeah, they won't be able to. They're spending all their money. Yeah, exactly.
They spent all their money on rolls.
They're gonna just think that meth means or bits means meth.
And we'll just get thousands of bits donated. They're like, what? We didn't get anything. All right, cold open. Okay, so here we go.
There's something about giving bits of it. It's kind of like a high.
Okay, so I already read you the basically the Icewind Dale becoming trapped in a perpetual winter, that kind of thing, and a little bit of information about the area. So we did that already. Let's see here. So we're going to the next town. And so, yeah. So basically, Goodmead, the thing you know about Goodmead is was founded by immigrants from Cholt and the Vihon Reach. Goodmead is nestled between Redwaters and a nearby evergreen forest. The town says squat dwellings are adorned with carvings of dinosaurs and serpents. It's overshadowed by the two-story structure of the Mead Hall. Its eaves carved and painted to resemble wyverns. Honey is the key ingredient in mead, so the town literally buzzes with the droning of bees, believe it or not. You know that every tavern in Icewind Dale is accustomed to receiving mead deliveries, and the town can't produce or deliver its mead fast enough. Okay, so that's one thing that you know. It's a small population of around 100 people. You know that let me get into this. There is a militia that helps the town. And what else here? That's about it right now. And let me see if I have a little map here.
Are we coming up from... No, we're coming from down south up.
Yes.
Okay.
Let's see. So, yeah. Let me get over here real quick. All right.
If we were to find a map of 10 towns in Goodmead on the internet, say if we were searching for it,
no.
Is that acceptable?
No.
I'm not saying I'm doing
it. I do have a map of Goodmead. I do have a good map map of Goodmead for you, so I'm going to put it up on the thing. Well, first, there's the symbol of Goodmead, which is that. Okay, you can see on your screen. Oops.
Wow.
Okay. Yeah, that is the symbol of
Goodmead.
Actually,
really cool mug.
Is that our future tavern?
Oh, maybe.
Isn't that the Lust King crest?
I don't know. The glass seems so curved, you're actually losing a lot of drink.
Actually, you don't.
Okay.
It's the same. It's just...
Yeah, it curves out on the left, so it curves in on the right.
Okay, map of Goodmead. There's the map of Goodmead. That is the map of Goodmead.
Hey.
And you are coming from the north. You are coming from the north into Goodmead. Okay. And let's see here. Right. Okay. You know that there is a path connects Goodmead to the east way, which crosses the snow-covered road and continues to Caer Dinnaval. There is another snowy path that leads to Dugan's Hole. Yeah. And, okay, there's a mead hall. There's other stuff in the town. Let me get down here. Okay. Okay. All right. So yeah. So you are dragging or walking into Goodmead, okay. And you notice that as you get there, party number one, you get there, you see the town. It's, you know, the people are walking around all you know, garment. You can't hardly recognize them. They're all in cold clothing, that kind of thing. There's a few people out and around, but mostly you don't see hardly anyone out on the street, which is not abnormal for any of the towns in 10 towns. People don't go out as much as they have to, unless they absolutely have to. And so as you're there kind of getting your bearings, looking around, you notice that coming from behind you, you see three people with ropes over their shoulders dragging something through the snow as you come in to get me.
A fine trophy.
I'm going
must
to try.
Must have been a good hunt.
I'm going to try to perceive what it is.
Okay.
Now we feast.
Well, they look like they're dragging some kind of large creature that kind of has a strange look to it. I don't know if you'd really know what it was in general. It has like some kind of thing coming out of the front of its face.
I think I know what it is because I speak the language, but do I need to do a check to know what that is to tell my fellow?
Well, you could do a knowledge check to see if you maybe know what it is.
What kind of knowledge?
Nature.
Yeah, yeah. Knowledge nature.
Nature.
Whoa, what?
Twelve.
Let me get the okay. 12. Okay, you think you maybe heard of those? They're kind of exotic, especially in Icewind Dale. But you've maybe heard some stories about them. You don't quite remember what the name of it was, but you think you've heard of. They come from some far distant land.
I was going to say, if Goodmead's founded by immigrants, he'd fit right in.
Yeah.
They have limits.
All right. All right. So yeah, you guys see that? You see these guys dragging this person in? What do you do?
I kind of look back and I go, "Hey, are you you okay back there? Can you get yourself up now?"
I think he's unconscious.
No, I'm still stirring a little bit.
Yeah, he's stirring, but he's very cold. He's really having trouble, getting his bearings, and he's basically got the starting stages of hypothermia. So,
come on, let's get him inside. I've seen this before.
He's gonna lose his foot in an hour.
is that a person?
I mean, yes, he is sentient.
Can I attempt to stand?
Sure.
Now that the snow's cleared a little, I mean, I'm assuming that as we're entering town, some of the snow's been cleared away.
Yeah.
I'm off my back and things like that.
Yeah.
I
walk over and try to help him with this hand. Okay. So, you know, between all of you guys trying to help him, you're able to pretty much get him.
Let me roll the dice before you say that.
Yeah, do that. Oh, yeah, that's true. That is true. This is true.
Natural one.
Okay.
Down.
So I got a 12.
Well, okay, well, that's better.
I got a 12 on my own.
That is better.
Better than every other attempt I've made.
12.
So she also got a 12.
Okay, that's good. That's better.
Okay.
Getting you guys over here and good meat real quick. All right. Yeah, you're going to be a little larger than you're supposed to be on this map, but... Is you're just walking in. Alright. Let me get you over there real quick. Mm-hmm. just a second. Let me grab the map here, move it over. All right, we're almost there. All right. Could be.
Oh.
Okay.
Good. I see a black square with just my face.
Save.
Really? Oh, wow. Yep.
I see a black square with John's face.
Okay, I know why. I have to give the map some light. Hang on just a second.
It's okay. I mean, you said there was no sun.
Yeah, it's just, you know.
That's how it looks.
Okay, oh. There you go.
Yeah.
The better?
No, giants!
Yeah, you guys are giants going into town.
Oh, no, attack of the giant baby! It's just out of dude now.
I like this campaign.
We're giants. Okay, so that gives you a little map of the town